Tony, to go back to a previous subject that you had mentioned, the history of this research, back in the 50s, a lot of studies were done with the research standards of the time. Mm-hmm. Can you talk a bit about why we can't use those studies now as evidence that they were done and when they have generally positive results that point the way, mm-hmm. but now it appears you're having to redo the research in another way. Can you address that?
Yeah, there's a number of issues. I mean, one of course is nothing replaces double blind control placebo studies like we have in today's science infrastructure.
And those were being done back in the 50s.
Some were. But even if they had the control placebo and were blinded, the research design, the various outcome measures they used weren't as elaborate. There weren't as many as we have today. Mm-hmm. And research design was at a very different place 40 mm-hmm. years ago. If they lacked the control or placebo or blindness, it clearly would be hard to cite that those results as powerful. Mm-hmm. But these days we have the ability to do these with placebo, double blind, control, and a host of measures. This current project looks at over 20 outcome measures, looking at mood, depression, anxiety, quality of life, spirituality, acceptance of death. There's a host of measures we look at that back then weren't available. There weren't that many measures available. Mm-hmm. But they're great studies. They really laid the groundwork for what was to become. And again, the loss of all those years that nothing happened because of the profound shifts in sociocultural, legal world that caused the this research to come to an end in the early 70s to mid-70s.